governor had some harsh comments last week about the city and its performance in this water dilemma. Mm-hmm. Can you address those comments and your thoughts?
Well, let me say this with respect to the city and its performance. I'm very clear on the record as to the historic challenges of our water system. I've been very clear on the numerous requests for years that have gone unheeded. And so I will just state that in terms of speaking to the city and in all of its efforts, not only the efforts of this administration, but the efforts of several administrations. I will say that when I heard of the comments that I had irrevocably destroyed the unified command, and I was sick in my bed, I was surprised because I didn't know how I did that from my bed, right? Also to find out that he had a number of statements. At the time that we were pardoning a turkey, I was really a bit afraid that the turkey might not get pardoned, you know, thinking of me in the entire process. But let me be clear on this. There are a number of things that he said, and I'm sure that you want to hear my response to that. First and foremost, I want to clarify a few things. One, the governor said that he's a big boy and he can handle any of my comments. If you have gone through not only the comments that I have made locally, but nationally, I have made no comments personally attacking the governor in any way. What I have done is put the onus or responsibility or accountability on all leadership to understand their role in how we found ourselves in these challenges. He also stated that I talked poorly, and it upset him when I talked poorly about the people of Mississippi. I think that you have to follow up with questions like, what did the mayor say about the people of Mississippi? Because you will find at no time in any of my comments have I ever spoken poorly about the people of Mississippi. I love the people of Mississippi. What I have done is challenge the leadership of the state in order to address the failure to fund Jackson over time. And so don't lump the people of Mississippi in your failure to fund the city of Jackson. He talked about how in his 19 years in public office, this is the first time that he's ever had to take over a water system, and we have thousands of water systems in the city, I mean the state. Well, first, his accounting of how many water systems we have in the state fails to recognize that there are only two in the state of Mississippi that are surface water systems. And the other one has been under conservatorship for some time now, right? And the city of Jackson has had its challenges, even though we've been enumerating all of these challenges in our need of funding. And so finally, we're on the precipice of working together in order to address those things. And he talked about his 19 years in public office, like I said, and never having to take over a water system. Well, first and foremost, he's only been in executive office for 3 years. You can't take over a water system as treasurer of the state, all right? And so it's just, you know, creating this picture that is unnecessary and that is unfruitful. We talked about, the fact that he needed to issue the RFP because the Biden administration, EPA's administration, was pressing him to do that. Only for us who have been in constant discussions with the EPA, with FEMA, with the Department of Health and all of these agencies to find out that they said that that was unequivocally false, that they had never told him that he needed to issue an RFP. And then in discussions with them, they asked that we hold our RFP for 48 hours just so that they could clarify any misunderstanding that the governor would had in their discussions with him, only to find out that the governor failed to take their call over that period of time. He just went radio silent on them and did not answer the call. So that was untrue there. He talked about the fact that I've destroyed the unified command. I met with the unified command today, as I do every Monday, in order to assess what is taking place, in order to get an update on the current status, intermediate status or plans for our plant and long-term plans for our plant. And so that was just patently false. It's a somewhat bipolar analysis that the governor has each and every day. On some days, I want to be the savior of Jackson's water system. I want you to know everything that we're doing and how we've rescued Jackson from this place. Then other days, it's, I want you to know how much disdain I have for Jackson by saying, it's always a great day not to be in Jackson. Or by, you know, bragging on how much money he turned down for the city of Jackson when he was state treasurer. Or talking about things that, you know, we just let it go, right? People joked about my expression in the press conference after he said it, when he talked about the $200 million that he had given to Jackson, only for him to issue a list that you yourselves know was laughable, right? It was laughable because it had funds that were loans that the city has to pay for, right? Unless they are forgiving these millions and millions of dollars of loans that we have to pay on, that we have to pay the administrative cost on, that we have to pay the low interest cost on, right? Then I don't know what you gave us, right? If these are loans that we're taking out. Or, you know, listing things like the 1% sales tax. The 1% sales tax was a decision of the residents of Jackson, right? In order to tax themselves. So the governor isn't giving anything when the residents of Jackson are deciding to add a penny on the goods and services that they purchase in order to address their infrastructure. Even when you take the CCID, the CCID is just an offset of Jackson tax dollars. What that means is that the projects that are accomplished by the CCID are an added carve out of Jackson taxes, right? So it's Jackson residents paying for Jackson infrastructure. And so when we make these statements, we gotta go through a fact by, don't make any generalizations about, you know, the city isn't doing this and I've given $200 million. We're gonna go to specifics and talk about it. Now, the reason that time and time again, I have decided to not address the governor. I have, well, not talk about the governor, not go tit for tat, and instead encourage cooperation. Every time a statement is made, every time he has a tantrum, what do I come back with you? I come back to you with facts. I come back to you with the details. And then I say, Governor, I hope that we can cooperate and work together. And the reason that I do that is, first and foremost, I don't care what the governor thinks about me. Let me just put that on the record. I do not care what he thinks about me. Secondly, I would say that we both have to understand that the challenges that we are addressing are bigger than me and bigger than him. It's about how do we restore a functional, dependable system for the residents of Jackson. This isn't about the mayor, and it's not about the governor. And so we have to keep that front and center in this process, right? And then the last thing that I will say, and I'm sure this will be the quotable, right? But John Henry Clark said it best. I only debate with my equals. All others, I teach. Next question.